Hey guys, I'm Theo. Welcome back to another Genshin video. In this video, I will be talking about one of the strongest support in game, XINGQIU'S. If you have just gotten your first copy of XINGQIU'S, or even a few of his constellations from the recent banner, please don't bench him. I will show you how to turn him into a broken support. Let's jump right in. As usual, to make a character stronger, we need to fully understand his kit. XINGQIU'S is well known as a top-tier support and sub-DPS. He has three main roles which make him such a broken character. First, he is an off-field burst support, meaning that he deals damage without needing to stay on the field for a long period of time. Second, he provides a very consistent hydro damage application. That is why XINGQIU'S is so good in almost every reaction team. Third, he increases the survivability of the active character by providing damage reduction and healing. Now, let's go through his skills. His elemental skill deals quite an amount of damage. After casting the skill, 3-4 hydro swords will orbit around the active character like a shield. The hydro swords reduce the damage taken by the active character based on XINGQIU'S hydro damage bonus. When the hydro sword shatters or its duration ends, it will also heal the active character. The amount of healing is based on 6% of XINGQIU'S max HP. Another purpose of his elemental skill is to get elemental particles to charge up his burst and acts as a battery for his party members. XINGQIU'S burst deals a huge amount of damage. After casting his burst, your active character's normal attacks will trigger 2-3 rain swords attacks that deal hydro damage. The rain sword attack animation is extremely fast. This is why XINGQIU'S is the best hydro aura applicator. Because he can apply hydro aura to enemies consistently. If you don't understand what I mean by aura applicator, I will make another video about elemental reactions. Subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification bell, so you will be notified when I post new content. Back to XINGQIU'S guide. Even if you are free to play and has limited resources to build him, he can still shine as a support. But the more you invest on him, the higher the damage he does. He works extremely well in any reaction team that requires hydro element. For example, you can pair him with a pyro DPS for huge reverse vaporize reaction. Pair him with a cryo DPS for permanent freeze reaction. Or pair him with an electro DPS for electrocharged reaction. So, XINGQIU'S build is quite straightforward. His only downside is energy recharge, because his burst requires 80 energy. Since XINGQIU'S is off the field most of the time, the window period for him to recharge his burst is only during her elemental skill. That's why his best weapon is Sacrificial Sword. It enables him to get the double amount of particles by casting his elemental skill twice. If you don't have Sacrificial Sword, or it's only at low refinement, other swords with energy recharge substat are also good for him. Artifact-wise, the Emblem of Severed Fate set is the current best in slot for him. The four-piece set not only provide energy recharge, but also increases his burst damage. Use four-piece Noblesse Oblige set if you aim to buff your DPS and don't mind losing out on XINGQIU'S damage. Two-piece Heart of Depth and two-piece Noblesse is an easier and balanced build before you get a decent four-piece set. For the artifact stats, optimally, he needs an energy recharger attack sand, hydro goblet and critical rate or critical damage circlet. Using an energy recharge sand is easier to solve his energy problem. He will need around 180% to 200% energy recharge to get a consistent burst uptime. If you already have enough energy recharge from the substats, then using an attack sands will give him more damage. To make him even better, you need to focus on getting high critical rate and critical damage substats from your artifacts. Some HP rolls in the substats are good if you are looking for more healing. For his constellations, C2, C3, and C6 are the best constellations. Anyway, he is definitely usable at C0. So, that's about it, my 5 minutes guide to make XINGQIU'S stronger. If you spend some time and resources to properly build your supports, you will be surprised how much damage they can do. If you find this video helpful and would like to see more Genshin content, Please leave a like and subscribe to support me and help with the YouTube algorithm. Thanks for watching, and I shall see you in my next video. Peace.